An Oklahoma mystery covers two generations.
During routine training, state troopers discovered two cars at the bottom of Foss Lake. That's about 200 miles from Tulsa, west of Oklahoma City on I-40. As News on 6 anchor Lori Fulbright tells us, the discovery has left a lot of questions. On the surface, six Oklahoma cold cases get solved. But for the families of the six people discovered inside those cars, the mystery of why they ended up at the bottom of that lake is far from over.
This was the way it was in 1970. This goes right down to the boat ramp.
Barry Hardaway is the park manager here at Foss Lake, a body of water that held a dark secret for more than 40 years.
There's a lot of ifs about the whole situation for both vehicles.
You can't rule out foul play.
Gary Williams was only 12 years old when his 16-year-old brother Jimmy went missing from Sayre in November of 1970.
He told Mom he was going to a ball game at Elk City.
He left with his friends Leah Johnson and Thomas Rios. They never came home. All three vanished without a trace.
First one that came into the screen was the Camaro.
Until last year, when troopers uncovered Jimmy's car doing routine sonar training, along with the remains of all three teenagers. But that wasn't all.
The next was the 53 Chevy.
Sitting next to the Camaro with the remains of three more people.
I was very suspicious that, you know, might have unearthed somebody's place they've been hiding bodies. Both those cars were sitting side by side.
Trooper George Hoyle says several theories evolved over the years.
The hippies kidnapped them, racism, Mexican drug cartel, serial killer.
You can hear all kinds of stuff.
William says his brother's disappearance always haunted the family.
You know, my mom was talking about it on her deathbed, you know. Every time Jimmy's birthday come around, she'd bake a cake, you know, maybe today's the day Jimmy comes home.
In the other car, 69-year-old John Porter was found along with his friends Nora Duncan and Cleburne Hammock. They were reported missing a year before the teenagers in 1969.
There was no trace at all. I mean, my grandpa just left his house. Cleburne left his job. Nora left her home. And they were gone.
The discovery gave the family some peace, but many questions remain.
I think that out of those six people, there would have been at least one person among the six would have got out.
You have three young kids in a muscle car, alcohol in the vehicle, probably just ran off the road and drowned.
However, Williams is not convinced his brother simply drove off into the lake.
I don't think it was an accident.
This is the shifting rod. If that's straight up and down, it's in neutral.
It rolled in there backwards. There's no doubt in my mind about that.
As for the Chevy,
a whole lot of things there that we really not able to determine.
There was alcohol inside, but no damage to the vehicle, and the driver's door was wide open.
It always felt like foul play, and that hasn't completely been ruled out of our hearts.
The medical examiner's report ruled all the deaths an accident due to probable drowning, which is unsettling for Williams.
It seems to me reasonable you check the unknown box, because really, we don't know what happened that night. They don't know, we don't know, nobody knows. Except God.
The discovery prompted OHP and Lake Patrol officers to search other Oklahoma lakes with their sonar equipment, but so far they have not turned up anything significant. Lori Fulbright, News on 6.